Hello, I'm Scott Mills from BBC Radio 1. This is Chris Stark, and we're in a room with Kevin Hart and Dwayne The Rock Johnson about to play Playground Insults.
Oh,
they are
no,
staring each other out.
This is the one.
The atmosphere in here is very tense.
You can cut it with a knife.
That's why I'm drinking my tea.
Kevin Hart is drinking from the smallest teacup in the world.
Well, it's befitting.
It's purposely.
Was that an insult?
I don't like big cups.
This is a safe zone. What gets said in this room goes absolutely no further.
All right.
You can feel the tension already. Okay, here we go. Kevin to serve.
DJ's got the same nose as Janet Jackson.
Here we go. He's taking the gloves off now. Yeah. This is it. All right. Kevin looks like a buffed Urkel.
A buffed Urkel. Okay. I'm going to go with your head looks like a long breast. Like a long, succulent breast.
Like with the areola right on my forehead.
Yeah, areola is right on your forehead. You got a nipple head.
That's fucked up. Guys, don't encourage him.
He's got a titty head.
Okay. He's got a titty head. That's going to stick.
That's going to stick.
If that shows up on my timeline, then...
You got a Portuguese titty head.
That's enough. Don't put a culture on it.
Put a culture on it.
Just a titty head is fine.
Portuguese titty head.
I really... All right. You know how sometimes when people get under your skin and you just hate them? I'm not
saying... What is that? What are you saying?
I'm not saying it's you. I'm just saying there's sometimes where you just really hate somebody. Sometimes because you have that personality when you walk in and you're like, you think everyone's like, hey, there's Kevin, great, but you know.
Dwayne Johnson's
don't say it.
Breath smells like shit on the regular. And nobody knows this. You wanna know where the eyebrow raise came from? It came from the reaction of people when he goes, hello. And everybody goes, that's what The Rock is cooking. Shitty breath.
Okay, don't encourage him. All right, my breath is not shitty. Look at these teeth.
Don't talk about teeth. You know, I'm insecure about my teeth.
You guys ever heard of Invisalign? Huh? Okay. Yeah, Kevin's now the spokesman for Invisalign. Because his bottom row of teeth, is like, they're having a fucking meeting and they're all unhappy right now.
I confided in you with that. I told you.
Well, look at the pictures lately. He's talking like this and he's trying to hide it. Yeah, it's okay.
It's very true right now. Dwayne Johnson has women's eyes. He's got women thighs.
What does that mean, though? Because these are sensitive times. I'd love to hear that. What does that mean that I got women's thighs?
It just means that you're a very...
No, but I mean, go ahead. It sounds like that's a wonderful rabbit hole you should go down right now.
You know what? I don't need to explain myself.
Please explain it to the world.
What does
women's thighs mean?
This isn't an explain game. This is an insult. Women have nice thighs. You shouldn't have their thighs. That's what I'm saying. Now, shut up, man. Okay, here's a good impression of Dwayne Johnson, the people's hero, okay? Mr. Dwayne, could you sign my belt? He's like, oh, come on, man. he throws kids off with signals to take their mind off of what they asked for. Mr. Dwayne, can I get an autograph?
Okay.
Hey. Kids confused as to what happened.
Well, the truth is, it's hard to insult Kevin because, you know, he's one of my best friends.
That's right.
Right? We mess around with each other a lot.
Big fan of all of his movies?
I loved all of his movies. That's the thing. I mean, Home Alone and...
No, that's not my movie.
I loved that one.
Those aren't my
Beverly
movies.
Hills Cop.
That's Eddie Murphy.
Away. What are you talking about?
That's not my movie.
Oh, you know what it was? No. Pootie Tang was great.
That's Chris Rock. Now you're just naming other black comedians. You're not even trying.
He's great.
Tell you a little secret about Dwayne.
He was
Dwayne,
great
nobody
in Smurfs. He was wonderful in that.
Dwayne's got a tattoo right above his ass that says, come on.
Kevin Hart, Dwayne Johnson, thank you for your playground insults.
Thank you, dude.
Of course, all jokes aside, man, look, you know, there's nothing but respect and admiration that goes for this
likewise.
Guy, man. I would love to call him a dickhead for the rest of this interview, but I love the jackass.
But I love the dude, too. I got to agree with you. You know what I mean? We're very similar in so many ways, and we share a lot of the same values, hard work and discipline and drive and, you know, having a great time, loving making people laugh. I'd love to sit and call him a real piece of shit for the whole time, but, you know, I can't.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Appreciate
it. It was good.